Good morning, students. Now we are starting a new unit, Laplace transforms. Right. Before starting this unit, let us, as usual, recall our course plan for the signals and systems. What is our course plan for signals and systems? Is that is the order of preparing this subject. What we need to study first is, first a detailed study of signals, and then systems, and then Laplace transforms, followed by Z transforms, followed by Fourier series and Fourier transform, then sampling theorem. And finally, a discrete version of Fourier transform. So I am going to cover one by one each topic or each unit with a detailed discussion and with clear examples, solved problems and gate previous problems. Right? Now we are in this unit, Laplace transforms. First let us see the plan of action for this Laplace transform. What we are going to cover in this Laplace transform unit is, first, I will give a brief introduction and then I will specify the ROC properties, and then based on ROC properties and Laplace transform formula, we are going to solve some standard signal Laplace transforms. So after finding the Laplace transform of some standard signals, we will see properties of Laplace transform. After completion of the properties with the proofs, we will solve some more problems based on the properties. And then I will cover inverse Laplace transform. Some procedures will be there. Finally, we will solve some gate previous problems. This is our plan of action for this Laplace transform unit. So in this video, just I will give a brief introduction. And then in the next video, I am going to give ROC properties with a clear description. Right. Let us see the introduction points about Laplace transform. Laplace transform, basically, it is a powerful mathematical tool which converts a signal from time domain to S domain. So we'll say x of t, generally any signal naturally available in the time domain. This will be converted to the S domain by using Laplace transforms. So any signal will be in time domain. So after applying this Laplace transform, we are converting into S domain. Here, what is S means? S is a complex variable. S is equal to sigma plus j omega, where sigma we are writing as real part of S, omega we are writing as imaginary part of S, and we will specify the signals in the S domain in this terminology by taking real part of S on the x-axis and imaginary part of X on the y-axis. Or simply we will represent like this, imaginary part of S. Real part of S. We will specify the locating poles and specifying the region of convergence, and we will have a lot of discussion about these ROC properties in the next video. Now S is a complex variable which is represented in terms of sigma plus j omega, and what is this formula for x of S? Here it is minus infinity to plus infinity x of t multiplied by e to the power minus st dt. This is the Laplace transform formula we are using to transform any signal from time domain to S domain. Let us substitute S value here, sigma plus j omega e power minus sigma t e power minus j omega t. So here, of course, this is x of S formula. this function multiplied by e power minus j omega t means it is nothing but the Fourier transform of this continuity. That we will discuss the relation between Laplace transform and Fourier transform while discussing Fourier transforms. Now, here sigma value decides. The sigma value actually it is from minus infinity to plus infinity. Here the range of values of sigma for which this x of s converges is we are calling as region of convergence. What is region of convergence means for a signal x of t, the range of values of sigma for which x of s converges is called as ROC. This ROC, a detailed discussion we will have in the next video. Let us meet in the next video.